press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Dear children, subject social science, topic Vijayanagara Empire. Class 7. In this class, I talk about Vijayanagara Empire. In this class, we discuss about Vijayanagara Empire. The expedition which started during 13th century by Delhi Sultan Alauddin Khilji over South India. 13ನೇ ಶತಮಾನದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅಲಾವುದ್ದೀನ್ ಖಿಲ್ಜಿ ದಕ್ಷಿಣ ಭಾರತದ ದಂಡಯಾತ್ರೆಯನ್ನು ಕೈಗೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಡ್ ಇನ್ 14th ಸೆಂಚುರಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಇವನ ದಂಡಯಾತ್ರೆಗಳು 14ನೇ ಶತಮಾನದವರೆಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಮುಂದುವರಿಯುತ್ತವೆ. ಆಸ್ ಎ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಮೆನಿ ಸೌತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಯಾದವ ಆಫ್ ದೇವಗಿರಿ, ಹೊಯ್ಸಳಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ್ವಾರ ಸಮುದ್ರ, ಕಾಕತಿಯಾ ಆಫ್ ವಾರಂಗಲ್, ಪಾಂಡ್ಯಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಧುರೈ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಡಿಫೀಟೆಡ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್? At this juncture, Vijayanagara succeeded in creating a strong political power as a solution for South India's political issues. It ruled for 3 centuries. ಈ ಹೊತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ದಕ್ಷಿಣ ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬ ಪ್ರಬಲವಾದ ಒಂದು ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯ ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆಯಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದು ಯಾವುದಪ್ಪ ಅಂದರೆ ವಿಜಯನಗರ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯ. ಇಟ್ ರೂಲ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ 3 centuries. 3 ಶತಮಾನಗಳವರೆಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಇವರು ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ನಡೆಸ್ತಾರೆ. In this lesson, the dynasties which ruled Vijayanagara Empire are explained, contribution of these kings to political, social, economical, literary, art and sculpture are also discussed here. Battle of Talikota, which was the main reason for the decline of Vijayanagara Empire. Battle of Talikota or Rakkasatangadi, which was the main reason for the decline of Vijayanagara Empire. Okay, the Vijayanagara Empire was founded in 1336 century. The Vijayanagara Empire was founded in 1336 century. Vijayanagara ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯವು 1336 ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆಯಾಗುತ್ತದೆ. ದ ವಿಜಯನಗರ ಎಂಪೈರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಫೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ 1336 ಸೆಂಚುರಿ. ದ ಸಂಗಮ ಸನ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಹರಿಹರ, ಬುಕ್ಕರಾಯ, ಕಂಪಣ, ಮಾರಪ್ಪ ಅಂಡ್ ಮುದ್ದಪ್ಪ. ದೇ ವರ್ ಫೌಂಡರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವಿಜಯನಗರ ಡೈನಸ್ಟಿ. ದೇ ವರ್ ದ ಫೌಂಡರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೈನಸ್ಟಿ. ಇಟ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಟೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ಸದರ್ನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಆಫ್ ತುಂಗಭದ್ರಾ ರಿವರ್. ಈ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯ ಯಾವ ನದಿಯ ದಡದ ಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆಯಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ತುಂಗಭದ್ರಾ ರಿವರ್. ಇಟ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಟೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ತುಂಗಭದ್ರಾ ರಿವರ್. ತುಂಗಭದ್ರಾ ರಿವರ್ their capital was Hampi. Vijayanagara Empire capital was Hampi of Ballari district. Their national emblem was boar, in Sanskrit Varaha. In Sanskrit Varaha. Their capital was Hampi. Their national emblem was Varaha or boar. Once again, the Vijayanagara Empire was founded in 1336 century. The founders of this dynasty, Harihara, Bukkaraya, Kampana, Marappa and Muddappa. They were the founders of the Vijayanagara dynasty. It's situated on Tungabhadra River. Their capital was Hampi. Their national emblem was boar. Boar means Varaha. In Sanskrit, we called Varaha. Can I ask some question, children? When did the Vijayanagara Empire founded? The Vijayanagara Empire was founded in 1336 century. Who are the founders of Vijayanagara Empire? The Sangama sons are called Harihara, Bukkaraya, Kampana, Marappa and Muthappa. They were the founders of this dynasty. Where it's situated? It's situated on southern part of southern bank of Tungabhadra River. There, which was the capital of Vijayanagara Empire? Their capital was Hampi. Their national emblem was Boar or Varaha. Understood, children? Next, how many dynasties were ruled Vijayanagara Empire? How many dynasties were ruled Vijayanagara Empire? Now we study about dynasties of Vijayanagara Empire. We study about dynasties were ruled Vijayanagara Empire during 1336 to 1646 century. The Vijayanagara Empire was ruled by four dynasties. How many dynasties? Ruled by four dynasties are called. First one is Sangama dynasty. That ruled from 1336 to 1485 century. 1336 to 1485 century. Next one is Saluwa dynasty. That ruled from 1485 to 1505 century. Third dynasty, Tuluwa dynasty. Third one is Tuluwa dynasty. That rule started 1505 to 1567 century. Last one is Aravedu dynasty. Fourth one, Aravedu dynasty. That ruled started from 1572 1567 century. Once again, see here children, Vijayanagara Empire was ruled by four dynasties. First one is Sangama dynasty, that ruled 1336 to 1485. Second one is Saluwa dynasty, from 1485 to 1505 century. Tuluwa dynasty, that ruled 1505 to 1567 century. Last one, Aravedu dynasty, that started from 1572 to 1646 century. These are the four dynasties were ruled Vijayanagara Empire. So children, first we are going to learn about first dynasty, that is Sangama dynasty. Now we study about Sangama dynasty. That started in year 1336 to 1485 century. Harihara was the first king of this dynasty. Harihara was the first king of Sangama dynasty. Harihara was the first king of Sangama dynasty. When Harihara took power, he extended his empire to Konkan coastal areas of the east. Of the west. Once again, I will repeat. ಈ ವಿಜಯನಗರ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯವನ್ನು ನಾಲ್ಕು ವಂಶದವರು, ನಾಲ್ಕು ಸಂತತಿಗಳು ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತವೆ. ಮೊದಲನೇದು ಸಂಗಮ ಡೈನಸ್ಟಿ. ಇವರು 1336 1485 ವಿಜಯನಗರ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯವನ್ನು ಆಳ್ತಾರೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸಾಳುವ ಸಂತತಿ. ಇವರು 1485 1505 ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ನಡೆಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ತುಳುವ ಡೈನಸ್ಟಿ. ಇವರು 1505 1567 ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕೊನೆಯದಾಗಿ ಅರವಿಡು ಸಂತತಿ. ಇವರು 1570 1646 ಕೂಡ ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ನಡೆಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಸಂತತಿ ಸಂಗಮ ಸಂತತಿ. ಹರಿಹರ ಸಂಗಮ ಸಂತತಿಯ ಮೊದಲನೇ ರಾಜ. ಹರಿಹರ ವಾಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೈನಾಸ್ಟಿ. ವೆನ್ ಹರಿಹರ ಟುಕ್ ಪವರ್, ಹಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಡೆಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಎಂಪೈರ್ ಟು ಕೊಂಕಣ್ ಕೋಸ್ಟಲ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಆಫ್ ದ ಈಸ್ಟ್. ಹಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಡೆಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಎಂಪೈರ್ ಕೊಂಕಣ್ ಕೋಸ್ಟಲ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಆಫ್ ಈಸ್ಟ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್, ನಾರ್ತ್, ಸೌತ್, ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ಟ್. ಹಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಡೆಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಎಂಪೈರ್ ಟು ಕೊಂಕಣ್ ಕೋಸ್ಟಲ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸಾರಿ ವೆಸ್ಟ್ He captured to Nellore and Kadapa of East. Who captured to Nellore and Kadapa? Harihara captured Nellore and Kadapa of East. To Nellore and Kadapa of East. The Krishna River of the North. He extended his empire, the Krishna River of North. And then Kaveri River of the South. Once again, Harihara extended his empire, Konkan coastal area of west and to Nellore and Kadapa of east, the Krishna river of north, the Kaveri river of south. He laid a strong foundation of his empire. He laid a strong foundation for his empire. Next, we study about Bukkaraya. Next, Bukkaraya ruled Sangama dynasty. Bukkaraya. Who was Bukkaraya? Bukkaraya was the brother of Harihara. He ruled from 1357 to 1377 century. He ruled 1357 to 1377 century. Bukkaraya became a king after Harihara. When Harihara died, after Harihara, Bukkaraya became a king of this dynasty. because he had no son. Bukkaraya had no son. Harihara had no son. That's why Bukkaraya became a king of Sangama dynasty. Understood, children? Bukkaraya was brother of Harihara. He ruled started from 1357 to 1377 century. Bukkaraya became a king after Harihara death because he had no son. During his rule, his son Kampana. Who was Kampana? Kampana was son of the Bukkaraya. During his rule, his son, Bukkaraya's son Kampana, expanded the empire by defeating the Sultan of Madurai. Who defeated the Sultan of Madurai? Kampana was defeated the Sultans of Madurai. And then he captured the Madurai. This success was explained in a book called Madura Vijayam. This success was explained in which book? Madura Vijayam. This was written by Kampana's queen, Ganga Devi. Who wrote the Madura Vijayam? Madura Vijayam wrote the Ganga Devi. Once again, who was the son of Bukkaraya? Kampana was the son of Bukkaraya. During his rule, his son Kampana expanded the whole empire by defeating the Sultan of Madurai. This success was explained in a book called Madura Vijayam. This book name was Madura Vijayam. Who wrote this book? Madura Vijayam wrote the Ganga Devi. Who was Ganga Devi? Ganga Devi, wife of Kampana. Next, Bukka captured Penukonda by defeating Reddy of Kondavidu. Next, Bukkaraya, he captured the Penukonda by defeating the Reddy leaders, Reddy of Kondavidu, and included it to Vijayanagara Empire. Shravanabelagola inscription of 1368 century explains that he pacified the conflict between Jains and Vaishnavas and maintained religion harmony and equality. Hariharan anantara Bukkaraya ee Sangama vamshavanna aalvike maartane. Bukkaraya Hariharanige makkalu illade iro karana Bukkaraya Sangama ಸಂತತಿಯ ರಾಜನಾಗಿ ನೇಮಕವಾಗ್ತಾನೆ. ಇವನು 1357 1377 ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ನಡೆಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಇವನ ಆಡಳಿತ ಅವಧಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇವನ ಮಗ ಕಂಪಣ ಏನ್ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಮಧುರಾಯನ ಸುಲ್ತಾನರನ್ನು ಸೋಲಿಸಿ ಆ ಮಧುರಾಯನ್ನು ತನ್ನ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಸೇರಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದ್ರ ಮೂಲಕ ತನ್ನ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯವನ್ನು ಬುಕ್ಕರಾಯನ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯವನ್ನು ಇವನು ವಿಸ್ತರಣೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಈ ಯಶಸ್ಸನ್ನು ಮಧುರಾ ವಿಜಯಂ ಎಂಬ ಪುಸ್ತಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವಳ ರಾಣಿ ಕಂಪಣನ ರಾಣಿ ಮಧುರಾ ವಿಜಯಂ ಎಂಬ ಪುಸ್ತಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದಾಳೆ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾಳೆ. ಬುಕ್ಕ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಚರ್ಡ್ ಪೆನುಕೊಂಡ. ನಂತರ ಬುಕ್ಕರಾಯ ಏನ್ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಪೆನುಕೊಂಡವನ್ನ ವಶಪಡಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅದನ್ನ ತನ್ನ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಸೇರಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಪೆನುಕೊಂಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರು ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆ ನಡೆಸ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ? ರೆಡ್ಡಿ ಆಫ್ ಕೊಂಡವೀಡು ಅವರು ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನ ನಡೆಸ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅವರನ್ನ ಸೋಲಿಸಿ ಈ ಪೆನುಕೊಂಡವನ್ನ ತನ್ನ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಸೇರಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಶ್ರವಣ ಬೆಳಗೋಳ ಇನ್ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್, ಇನ್ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಶಾಸನ. ಶ್ರವಣ ಬೆಳಗೋಳ ಶಾಸನದಲ್ಲಿ 1368 ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿ ಪೆಸಿಫೈಡ್, ಅಂದರೆ ಇವನ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಂತಹ ಜೈನರು ಮತ್ತು ವೈಷ್ಣವರ ನಡುವೆ ಕಲಹ ಉಂಟಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಇವರ ನಡುವಿನ ಕಲಹವನ್ನು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಈ ರಾಜ ಬಗೆಹರಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಧರ್ಮ ಧರ್ಮ ಸಹಿಷ್ಣುತೆಯನ್ನ ಇವನು ಕಾಪಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ. ಯಾರು? ಬುಕ್ಕರಾಯ. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಬುಕ್ಕರಾಯ, ಹರಿಹರ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, ಬುಕ್ಕರಾಯ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, ವಿರೂಪಾಕ್ಷ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, ದೇವರಾಯ ಫಸ್ಟ್, ವೀರರಾಯ ರೂಲ್ಡ್ ವಿಜಯನಗರ ಎಂಪೈರ್. ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ children, next we study about Devaraya second or Proudha Devaraya. We know about the famous or strong kings. First one is Harihara and Bukkaraya, and then we study about Proudha Devaraya or Devaraya second. Devaraya second or Proudha Devaraya, he ruled between 1424 to 1446 century. Understood? Devaraya second or Proudha Devaraya, he ruled 1424 to 1446 century. He was the famous king of Sangama dynasty. After he took over the power, he built a new army including Muslim soldiers who were skilled in archery and horse taming. Horse taming. ಪ್ರೌಢ ದೇವರಾಯ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬ ತುಂಬ ಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧಿ ಪಡೆದಿರುವಂತಹ, ತುಂಬ ಬಲಶಾಲಿಯಾಗಿರುವಂತಹ ರಾಜ ಎಂದರೆ ಪ್ರೌಢ ದೇವರಾಯ. ಇವನ ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆ 1424 1446 ಪ್ರೌಢ ದೇವರಾಯ ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯನ್ನು ನಡೆಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಯಾವಾಗ ಅವನು ಆಳ್ತವನ್ನ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಹೊಸದಾದ ಆರ್ಮಿಯನ್ನು ಅವನು ಕಟ್ತಾನೆ. ಆ ಆರ್ಮಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ ಸೈನಿಕರನ್ನು ಸೇರಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಆ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ ಸೈನ್ಯ ಯಾವುದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಪುಣತೆಯನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿತ್ತು? ಆರ್ಚರಿ, ಬಿಲ್ಲು ವಿದ್ಯೆ ಮತ್ತು ಕುದುರೆ ಸವಾರರಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರು ತುಂಬ ನಿಪುಣತೆಯನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿದ್ರು. ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ ಸೋಲ್ಜರ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಡಿಫೀಟೆಡ್ ರೆಡ್ಡಿ ಲೀಡರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೊಂಡವಿಡು ರೀಜನ್. ಈ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ ಸೈನಿಕರ ಸಹಾಯದಿಂದ ಪ್ರೌಢದೇವರಾಯ ರೆಡ್ಡಿ ಲೀಡರ್ಸನ್ನು ಸೋಲಿಸಿ ಕೊಂಡವೀಡನ್ನು ವಶಪಡಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಹಿ ಡಿಫೆಂಡೆಡ್ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಮುದುಗಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಟ್ ರಾಯಚೂರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಂಕಾಪುರ್ ಬೈ ಫೈಟಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಅಹಮದ್ ಶಾ ಆಫ್ ಬಹಮನಿ. He defended famous Mudugal Fort Raichur and Bankapur by fighting with Ahmad Shah of Bahmani Sultans. He had the brave commander called Lakkanna Dandesha. He had brave commander. His name Lakkanna Dandesha. Who was he? He was the brave commander of Proudha Devaraya. His brave commander called Lakkanna Dandesha defeated the kings of Kerala and Sri Lanka. He defeated the kings of Kerala and Sri Lanka. And collected the treasure and tribute in cash from them. Proudha Devaraya oba daksha commander dandadhikariyanna hondirtane. Avana hesaru Lakkanna Dandesha. Ee Lakkanna Dandesha Kerala matte Sri Lanka da rajaranna solisi alli aa rajarinda en martane kappa kaanikeyanna vasuli martane. Next, Proudha Devaraya, he had religious tolerance, built Jain and Vaishnava temples in the capital, and he permitted to build mosques also. Proudha Devaraya sarva dharma sahishnu agirodrinda ivanu tana rajdhaniyalli aneka Vaishnava temples galanna matte ಹಿ ಗೇವ್ ಪರ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಟು ಮುಸ್ಲಿಮ್ಸ್. ಮುಸ್ಲಿಮರಿಗೆ ತಮ್ಮ ಮಸೂತಿಗಳನ್ನು ಕಟ್ಟಿಕೊಳ್ಳಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಅವನು ಪರ್ಮಿಷನ್, ಅವಕಾಶವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ, ಅನುಮತಿಯನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾನೆ. ಪ್ರೌಢದೇವರಾಯ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ರಿಲಿಜಿಯಸ್ ಟಾಲರೆನ್ಸ್, ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಜೈನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೈಷ್ಣವ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಪರ್ಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ ಮಾಸ್ಕ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಹಿ ಗೇವ್ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಟು ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಪೋಯೆಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್. ಪ್ರೌಢದೇವರಾಯ ಗೇವ್ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಟು ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ poets in his kingdom, like Telugu poet Srinatha, Sanskrit philosopher Dindima, and Kannada poet and the minister Lakkanna Dandeshwar patronized in his kingdom, Veerashaivism got resurrected in his period. Persian ambassador Abdul Razak visited Vijayanagara kingdom during Prouadadevaraya period and he stated, I have seen such a rich kingdom like Vijayanagara kingdom for the first time. The capital has 7 forts and the Raja's army has lakhs of soldiers. Once again, Persian ambassador Abdul Razak, he visited the Vijayanagara empire. Empire king during Prouadadevaraya period, he stated, I have seen such a rich kingdom like Vijayanagara kingdom for the first time. The capital has 7 forts and the Raja's army has lakhs of soldiers. Persia da rayabhari agiruvanta Abdul Razak ಈ ವಿಜಯನಗರ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಭೇಟಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಯಾವಾಗ ಅಂದರೆ ಪ್ರೌಢದೇವರಾಯನ ಆಳ್ವಿಕೆಯ ಅವಧಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪರ್ಷಿಯಾದ ಅಬ್ದುಲ್ ರಜಾಕ್ ಈ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಭೇಟಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಆವಾಗ ವಿಜಯನಗರದಂತಹ ಸಂಪದ್ಭರಿತವಾದ ರಾಜಧಾನಿಯನ್ನು ನನ್ನ ಕಣ್ಣುಗಳು ಮೊದಲ ಬಾರಿಗೆ ನೋಡುತ್ತಿವೆ. ನಗರಕ್ಕೆ 7 ಕೋಟೆಗಳ ಆವರಣ ಇದೆ. ರಾಯನ ಪ್ರೌಢದೇವರಾಯನ ಸೇನೆ ಲಕ್ಷಾವಧಿ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ ಎಂದು ಅವನು ವರ್ಣಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಪ್ರೌಢದೇವರಾಯ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ದ ಟೈಟಲ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಗಜಬೆಂಟಿಗಾರ. Which titles he had? First one is Gajabentegara. Second one is Chatu Samudra Dishwara. Another one is Ariraya Vibhada. These are the titles of Devaraya II. He had titles, first one is Gaja Bentegara, Chatu Samudradishwara and Ariraya Vibhada. After his death, he died in 1446 century. His son Mallikarjuna, he ruled between 1446 to 1465 century. And then Virupaksha III ruled Vijayanagara Empire. These were weak rulers and because of this reason, a strong commander Salva Narasimha captured the capital of Sangama dynasty. With this incident, the rule of Sangama dynasty ended in 1485 century. Next, we study about second dynasty, Salva dynasty. They ruled from 1485 to 1505 century. After taking over the power in 1485 century, Salwa Narsimha ruled for 6 years. He ruled only 6 years, but unfortunately he died in 1491 century. His children were minors, and one more thing is, his children were minor when he died. When Salwa Narsimha died, his children were minor. Because of this, kingdom was in the protection of a commander called Tuluva Narasanayaka. Tuluva Narasanayaka, from 1491 to 1503 century, Salwa dynasty over here. Once again, I will repeat. See here, Salwa dynasty, they ruled from 1485 to 1505 century. After taking over the power in 1485 century, Salwa Narsimha ruled for only 6 years and died in 1491 century. And one more thing is, his children were minors when he died. Because of this, kingdom was in the protection of a commander called Tuluva Narasanayaka. From 1491 to 1503 century, Salwa dynasty over here. Thank you, children.